Hello and welcome to our fourth episode of 2 Minute Tuesdays with Certus. I'm Carlson and this week our topic is what is mechanical smoke ventilation? Let's start the timer and find out. Mechanical smoke ventilation is smoke ventilation that does not rely on the natural buoyancy of the smoke and gas, but rather relies on powered fan sets to provide smoke ventilation. Mechanical systems are often referred to as pressure differential systems, and sometimes you will see them marked up on plans and specifications as MSVS, which stands for mechanical smoke ventilation systems. Reasons for using a mechanical smoke ventilation system include greater flexibility with building layout and design. With a mechanical system, we can have longer and more complex corridor designs. This is because it falls outside of the scope of approved document B. With a mechanical system, you can also have a smaller shaft. You can go as low as a 0.6 square meter shaft, as opposed to a 1.5 square meter shaft with a natural system. This provides a lot of space saving on every floor. There are two main types of mechanical system: a pressurisation system or a depressurisation system. Pressurisation systems push air into a building, creating a zone of higher pressure, which forces smoke away from a protected zone out through an outlet. They are more widely used in Europe than in the UK, and when they are used in the UK, they are typically only used in large office blocks. This is due to the challenges associated with servicing and maintaining the air outlets. Depressurisation systems work in reverse. They create an area of lower pressure by sucking smoke from the protected zone and thus protecting the escape route. Depressurisation systems are commonly used in the UK and are often found in high-rise residential buildings. The main products used in the mechanical system include fan sets, air inlet vents, shaft dampers, and control systems. The main bits of certification and guidance for mechanical smoke ventilation systems are EN12101-6, Specification for Pressure Differential Systems, the Smoke Control Association, or SCA, guide, and BS 9991 and BS 9999. Mechanical systems do usually require a greater initial investment than natural systems. However, this is often offset by the ability to have a smaller smoke shaft, and also through greater efficiencies in corridors due to more flexibility with design. Before I finish up, there are three key things to be aware of. Dampers used in mechanical systems must be certified to EN12101-8, not EN12101-2. Every mechanical system requires a computational fluid dynamic, or a CFD, to prove it. Mechanical systems require both primary and secondary power supplies. I've provided more information on that in the linked white paper. That brings me to the end of another 2 Minute Tuesday. I'm sorry we went just over time on that, but I hope this was useful to you and gave you a bit of an overview of mechanical systems. If you've still got questions, reach out to me directly or drop me a comment below. As always, I'm really grateful for any topic suggestions that you might have. Be free to put them in the comments below too. Thanks again for watching and take care. I'll see you next week.